When we look at an exascale machine, for example, what's out of Oak Ridge that's on the top 500 list, that machine can do a billion operations per second, or 10 to the 18th, which is exascale operations per second. It requires about 20 megawatts. When you look at 20 megawatts, over the course of a year, that can cost about $500,000 to $1 million to maintain that amount of power to the system. So when you look at microelectronics, the amount of power that's needed with different devices that are making up this different systems, that power is needed for cooling the system such that it doesn't overheat, because it needs to maintain at a certain temperature. So when we look at the power requirements, there's significant work to be done to decrease the power requirements with microelectronics. And if we look at it in terms of energy, so energy is the average power over time, then you're looking at microelectronics that go faster, and that means less time, or using less power, or a combination of both.
Although microelectronics experienced a steady improvement in performance in decades, nowadays microelectronics industry faces significant technical and economic challenge to continuously increase transistor density within a single chip. For example, in an Intel 10 nanometer chip, there are 100 million of transistors within an area of 54 by 44 nanometer squares. At this scale, it's extremely difficult for further density increment of transistors. The current computing processors are designed in the way that the computing unit and memory unit are separate. During computation, data is shuffled back and forth between the two units, generating heat and consume energy. With the increasing number of electronic devices, data transfer scale, and computing capacity, the energy required for microelectronics-related activity becomes a significant limit. The application of microelectronics has extended from computation and communication to a more diverse set of needs fueled by enhanced mobility, flexibility, and customizability, which requires different materials and manufacturing solutions than the traditional semiconductor clean room processing, especially when energy and environmental costs are considered. Additive manufacturing that fabricates electronic devices using organic and nanomaterials and digitally controlled processing is developed within this context. The additive manufacturing has the advantage of low material waste and thermal budget. It also provides opportunities for manufacturing close to the point of use, and thus leading to a reduced dependence on the semiconductor centralized fabrication facilities and global supply chains.